Back to the channel. So in today's video we're over on Liz Clocher Bog just outside Delvin in County Westmeath, and I'm going with my dad and my granddad, and we're going to meet my granduncle, who's explaining a bit about the bog, family history on the bog. Which, so my great granddad had been drawing turf off the bog on Lorry for over 80 years. So let's get into the video.
The O'Reillys had been on my father, your grandfather was cutting turf here in the 50s and 40s.
Right.
Not just here, but not too far from here, up Cairns, Tom, you know where I'm talking about. And that was with the slain turf was called.
Hand-won
turf. They'd be digging a house with a thing like a spade out with it, and fella be catching it, and Tom, your grandfather, was often there wheeling it out or whatever, and they reared it that way. And then in the 60s, early 60s, Bord na Mona started cutting turf big time. So then that kind of finished a lot of the slain turf, the hand won turf. And my father started drawing turf then from the board, just going and getting a lot of turf, and that went on for years. But then in the 80s, turf start getting scarce, kind of, in Bord na Mona, and people start cutting their banks again. And they started off with the sausage turf, as you said.
Yeah.
And then the sausage turf wasn't great, because they just dig it out of the bog there. And after a few years, the bog would flood. It did whatever it did, it didn't drain. So then they decided to do these hoppers. And that's what that is, hopper turf. And it's taken off, they take the top of the face bank, take the top of it 3 or 4 foot down, or maybe more, and then under that then is the black turf, the good enough turf that's under that. And that's what they put into the hoppers, bring it out there with that big tractor and their machine behind it, and they just spread it along there. There's four sods in a hopper there, each hopper. And they spread them along until the hopper is finished, and that's what they do. And then you know the rest. You have to let it dry for 3 or 4 weeks, and after that then you can turn it, which is what I do. I don't foot turf, I turn it.
Okay.
But a lot of people will turn it and then foot it.
Yeah.
Footing turf is putting sods on top of one another.
Yeah, like a Jenga.
And they leave it there. You probably have done that yourselves anyway. And that's it. We're out where we are now in the wilderness here.
Mm-hmm.
But as we said, coming in, you're probably looking at the last year or two of turf being cut, with the environmental and all this kind of thing, you know. So that's about all I know about turf.
Yeah, that's great.
I would start with my father.
Yeah.
And then my father, when he passed, your grandfather, or your
great grandfather
passed away, then I was still at it for 20 years.
Was that on a lorry or?
Yeah, with a lorry, yeah. And it was beginning to dwindle, so I gave it up, and now I'm grinding hens and chickens for my sins. You can cut that bit out. But the only thing about cutting turf is that you see what, now he's good with a machine.
Yeah.
There's no mess. But all that stuff there is the fertile part of the bog. This here. You see what he takes off the top?
Yep.
That's the fertile. When you go down to the black stuff, that's not, it's like land. You know what I mean? It's not fertile. So it's all, you know, it'll all redamage itself. You know. It'll all go back to where it was, like hundreds of years ago.
Yes, you're only taking a chunk and then everything else.
He only took. That would have been just. See where it finished there?
Yeah, yeah.
He only took a bit out of that there. So in 100 years' time, the still most of it would be there. It goes back about 60 metres.
Okay.
But then, even after that,
yeah,
there's turf, you know. But Bordermona have cut all the. That bog goes way up for nearly half a mile or a mile. This slaughter, Tom,